couple of months ago, I told you that if you're only listening to the mainstream media, you'd think the Trump administration has sat on its hands regarding the coronavirus. But that couldn't be further from the truth. The accomplishments are pages long. Go. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, the media in this country have done a great job in pushing propaganda. They are demagogues who are in the back pocket of the Democrat Party, as they were against Lincoln, as they were against Reagan, as they were against all Republican presidents, but especially Trump. They hate Trump the most. And they hate Trump the most because they feel they're on the precipice of taking over the government through the Democrat Party, and this president will not bend, he will not kneel, he will not accept what it is that they're trying to do to the country and to the people of this country. Quickly, I want to hit the coronavirus. I know you're upset about the coronavirus, but to be upset about the president of the United States is truly absurd, particularly when you consider that Joe Biden and the Democrats have done absolutely nothing to fight the coronavirus except sit back and attack the president of the United States. And their record is clear. They were pushing impeachment at the beginning of the virus. They were playing down the virus. Nancy Pelosi was in Chinatown. They didn't want you to call it the Wuhan China virus and all the rest. But they were never in the game. They were never doing anything. I want to show you this list. The list has so many points on it of what President Trump and his administration have done from the early days into March, just from the early days into March to address this pandemic. We have never seen anything like this in American history. Joe Biden had his chance in 2009. They blew it with the swine flu. There would have been mass deaths if the swine flu was as deadly as the coronavirus. They lucked out. But this president has had to wrestle this virus to the ground. In addition to this list that you're looking at, the president pushed and pushed hard Operation Warp Speed, spent millions in developing vaccines and therapeutics, millions given to Johnson & Johnson in March, millions given to Moderna in April, millions given to AstraZeneca in May, large-scale manufacturing. Once they gave money for the development of a vaccine, then they had to spend an enormous amount of money contracting for large-scale manufacturing. And they did that in June, on July 7, July 22, July 23. In August, they had to think about what? Not only manufacturing, but distribution. So they had to, again, enter into contracts with distribution. They are creating 100 million vials of vaccine with every one of these companies in anticipation of the vaccine working. If it doesn't work, they'll get rid of them. But if it does work, they're going to have those vaccines ready to go. They're going to have distribution ready to go. The development ready to go. We have never seen anything like this in American history dealing with any pandemic, and even in recent American history. Now, why is that? Because Donald Trump hasn't been in the government for 47 years. Donald Trump has been in the private sector. So he knew that you have to develop a vaccine. He knew that you have to manufacture a vaccine. He knew that you had to distribute a vaccine. And we will have a vaccine in the next few weeks. Thanks to Operation Warp Speed. We would not have an Operation Warp Speed, but for President Donald Trump and his experience as an outsider, a businessman. And he insisted that these bureaucracies in the federal government, and there are healthcare bureaucracies in the federal government, that they follow the rules, but they cut the red tape so we can save as many lives as possible. Shame on Joe Biden and the Democrats blaming every single death from this virus on the President of the United States. It is the most grotesque, unconscionable exploitation of a public crisis in modern American history.